Hello and welcome to the Daily Poem. I'm Heidi White, filling in for David Kern. Today I'm going to read to you a poem by Edna St. Vincent Millay. Millay was an American poet and a playwright, and she received the Pulitzer Prize for Poetry in 1923, and she was only the third woman to win the award for poetry. So she was a prestigious poet in her lifetime. She lived from 1892 to 1950. Today I'm going to read to you a poem called God's World. O world, I cannot hold thee close enough. Thy winds, thy wide gray skies, thy mists that roll and rise, thy woods this autumn day that ache and sag and all but cry with color, that gaunt crag to crush, to lift the lean of that black bluff. World, world, I cannot get thee close enough. Long have I known a glory in it all, but never knew I this. Here such a passion is as stretcheth me apart. Lord, I do fear thou'st made the world too beautiful this year. My soul is all but out of me. Let fall no burning leaf, prithee, let no bird call. I really love this poem. Millay was known for her formal poetry. It had a regular rhythm and rhyme. She was a master of the sonnet. In fact, Richard Wilbur said of her that she wrote some of the best sonnets of the century, and that means a lot coming from such an accomplished poet as he was. And he's right, she really mastered the form. Now, this is a 14-line poem, God's World is, but it's not a sonnet. It doesn't have the rhyme scheme, it doesn't meet the criteria for being a sonnet, but it does have a very regular rhythmic pattern and form to it. O world, I cannot hold thee close enough. You see, it flows off your tongue like music. So it does have that form, the formal elements of a regular rhythm, a regular rhyme, a beautiful internal rhymes like this line right here, to crush, to lift the lean of that black bluff. You hear that alliteration there with black bluff and lift the lean. And then the assonance with crush and bluff. It doesn't exactly rhyme, but it almost rhymes. And the vowel sounds are the same and kind of balance out that line from the beginning to the end. So she weaves that beautiful, formal intermingling of meter and rhyme within this lovely poem. But what stands out to me in reading this is the interruptions to that, that let us know that she's not only having a patterned kind of poetic experience that lends itself to this regular formal elements that kind of describe it. No, what's going on with her is that she is having an emotional experience with nature. She's probably on a walk. It doesn't say that within the poem, but it talks about the skies and to lift the lean of that black bluff. It seems like she's kind of walking by a bluff that looks like it's leaning over and about to fall, and the colors of the autumn sky are exploding. That's a very descriptive poem. And there's exclamation points everywhere. If you get a chance to look at the poem, there's dashes and exclamation points. So intermingled with this formal mastery of regular rhythm and rhyme and alliteration and assonance and the formal elements that poets use to beautify their experiences and thoughts, there's also this sense of interruption, as if she's crawling out of her skin. She's crying out, "Thou's made the world too beautiful this year." There's dashes in the middle of the lines. There's exclamation points. There's interruptions within her thoughts that communicate in the midst of this formal perfection. Something beyond herself is happening. She's encountering transcendence in a way that she can't really express, and yet she's attempting to as a poet using these formal elements. So there's that tension, that paradox between, I want to create something regular and patterned and formal and beautiful, but I also have to express the emotion that this experience is bringing to me, that sense that we all have had in encountering something beautiful in nature that makes us want to reach out beyond ourselves, the sense that there's something that words cannot capture, something indescribable and something transcendent. And Millay does that in a lot of poems, but there's something about this particular one, about the beauty of an autumn day, that just speaks to me and expresses that tension and that paradox and that poetic stretching that happens when a poet wants to describe something that's beyond description. So here it is again, God's World by Edna St. Vincent Millay. O world, I cannot hold thee close enough, thy winds, thy wide gray skies, thy mists that roll and rise, thy woods this autumn day that ache and sag and all but cry with color, that gaunt crag to crush, to lift the lean of that black bluff. World, world, I cannot get thee close enough. Long have I known a glory in it all, but never knew I this. Here such a passion is as stretcheth me apart. Lord, I do fear thou'st made the world too beautiful this year. My soul is all but out of me. Let fall no burning leaf, prithee. Let no bird call. This has been The Daily Poem. We'll see you next time with another poem. Mm-hmm.